guys, welcome back to my channel. This time we will discuss about economics expansion. So here we go, let's see the video. And economics expansion is an increase in the level of economic activity and of the goods and service available. It is a period of economic growth as measured by areas in real GDP. The explanation of fluctuations in aggregate economic activity between economic expansion and contraction is one of the primary concerns of microeconomics. Typically, an economic expansion is marked by an upturn in production and utilization of resources. Economic recovery and prosperity are two successive phases of expansion, whereas a recession is defined as the declining period of GDP. Expansion may be caused by factors external to the economy, such as weather condition or technical change, or by factors internal to the economy, such as fiscal policies, monetary policies, the availability of credit, interest rates, regulatory policies, or other impacts on producer incentives. Global condition may influence the level of economic activity in various countries. Economic contractions and expansion related to the overall output of all goods and services. Will the terms inflation and deflation refer to increasing and decreasing price of commodities, goods, and services in relation to the value of money? Expansion means enlarging the scale of a company. The ways of expansion include internal expansions. Means a company enlarges its scale, starts opening branches, investing new products, or developing new businesses. Internal expansion means a company enlarges its scale, starts opening branches, investing new products, or developing new business. Integration means a company integrates its scale through taking over or merging with other companies. Interest rate and interest rate is the amount of interest paid per period as a proportion of the amount of loans, deposits, or borrows are called the principal sums. The total interest on a amount of loans or borrows depends on the principal sums. The interest rate, the computing frequency, and the length of time over which it is when deposits are borrowed. The annual interest rate is the rate over a period of 1 year. Other interest rates vary over different periods, such as a month or a day, but they are usually annual. The interest rate has been characterized as an index of the preference for a dollar of present or incomes over a dollar of future incomes. The borrower wants or needs to have money sooner rather than later, and is willing to pay a fee in the interest rate for this privilege. Inflation factors. Interest rates vary according to the government directives to the central banks to accomplish the government's goals. The currency of the principal sum loans or borrowers, the terms to maturity of the investment, the perceived default probability of the borrowers, supply and demand in the market, the amount of collaterals, special features like cost provision, reserve requirements, compensation dealings, as well as other factors. Examples: a company borrows capital from a bank to push assets for its business. In return, the bank charges the company interest on the lender name. May also require over the new assets as collateral. A bank will use the capital deposit to individual to make loans to their clients. In return, the bank should pay individual who have deposited their capital interest. The amount of interest payment depends on the interest rate and the amount of capital they deposit. Real terms with reduced refers to the annual least effective interest rate over an overnight deposit between the central bank or other monetary authority. The annual percentage rate or APR may refer either to a nominal APR or an effective APR or a APR. The difference between the two is that the APR account for fees and components, while the nominal APR does not. The annual equivalent rate or a IR also called the effective and audit is used to help consumers compare products with different accounting references on account sales, but does not account for fees. I discount it is helpful to calculate friction value. For an interest-bearing security, coupon rate is the ratio of the annual coupon amount on the coupon paid per year. Per unit of portfolio where assurance yield is the ratio of the annual coupon difference paid at insurance market price. Yield to maturity is a bunch expected internal rate of returns. Assuming yield will be held to maturity, that is the discount rate with average all remaining cash flows to the investor or all remaining coupons and repayment of the fair value at maturity. With the insurance market price based on the banking business, there are deposit interest rates and loan interest rates. Based on the relationship between supply and demand of market interest rates, there are fixed interest rates and floating interest rates. Monetary policy interest rate targets are a vital tool of monetary policy and are taken into account when dealing with variables like investment, inflation, and unemployment. The central banks of countries generally tend to reduce interest rates when they bias to increase investment and consumption in a country economy. However, a low interest rate as a macroeconomic policy can be risky and may lead to the creation of an economic bubble, in which large amounts of investment are poured into the real estate market and stock market. In default economies, interest rate adjustments are used made up to keep inflation within a target range for the health of economies activities. Or cut the interest rates currently with economic growth to safeguard economic momentum. History. In the past two centuries, interest rates have been variously set either by national government or central banks. For example, the Federal Reserve Federal Funds Rate in the United States have varied between about 0.25% and 19%, whilst the Bank of England's base rate varied between 0.5% and 15%, and Germany experienced rates close to 19% and down to about 2% in the during an attempt to tackle spiraling hyperinflation. The central banks of Zimbabwe increased interest rates for borrowings to 800%. The interest rates on prime credit in the last and early were far higher than has been recorded, higher than previous U.S. presidents. The British big century or the Dutch big century modern capital market comes into existence. There have never been such high long-term stretches as in the period.